You guys like comedy?
Yes.
Yeah.
You guys gonna hate this. Yeah. So let's start with a bit of audience participation. So you look like you're not from here, around here. Where are you from?
What do you mean where I'm from?
It's a question like, which country were you born? Oh,
country? Okay. Oh, Georgia.
Georgia? You're American?
Georgia.
There's a country called Georgia? I have no idea. You must forgive me, I'm
from Korea. Don't worry.
I don't really care about Indian countries. So what's your name here? What's your name, bro?
Temuka.
Sorry, so what?
Temuka.
It's like a drink.
Don't worry about it.
What do people call you?
Call me Tim.
Tim, oh, Tim. So what are you doing here, Tim?
Looking at you.
What are you doing in Singapore, man?
Oh, just visiting for a short time, actually.
Oh, you're right. Can I?
No, just my family lives here.
Oh, the family is here. That's cool. Okay, what I can say about that was you sound like a serious guy. I feel so bad for making fun of you. What about you, man? Where are you from?
I'm from London.
London?
Mm.
Oh, where?
The city, not the
city. Just in case.
What are you doing here, man?
I'm working
here.
At NUS.
At NUS? And you came to NTU?
What?
And you came to NTU too?
Yeah, I know, right?
Wow. That's hardcore, man.
Over the mountains.
Normally, we don't really get NUS people in NTU. They try to avoid this place.
Yeah.
Yeah. Normally, they bring their passports along as they come to NTU. So, what are you working at NUS at?
A writer.
Oh, you're a writer? Mm. Wow. First writer person I've met in real life. Yeah, I don't know anybody who is a professional writer. Maybe. Yeah, because I'm from engineering background, so you get the idea, right?
Yeah, that is unfortunate.
Okay, Singapore NTU is I was telling one uncle that somebody I met that he asked me which school I'm from, so I told him I'm from NTU. He said, "Huh, what? It's like NTU is like not spelled wrongly." So I was thinking that actually NTU. Singapore is so hyped up over acronyms. Do you guys notice that when you're here?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, like a bit crazy over acronyms. In fact, when because we have a lot of Chinese students here in Singapore, and one of the number one things these Chinese students always mention is that not only do we speak bad English, which is Singlish. Like we call our bad English Singlish as like an excuse to not speak proper English. We speak in acronyms as well. But I found a way to justify our acronyms to the Chinese students here in NTU. I tell them that our acronyms are like their Chinese, you know, because it's like idioms. How do I explain this? This joke is supposed to be in front of Chinese people. So basically, Chinese words have phrases that mean a lot in forwards. Are you aware of this? Yeah, you're aware of this, right? So our acronyms are just like that. So basically, NTU stands for Nanyang Technological University. But we sometimes take it a step further. Sometimes our acronyms mean so much, you don't need to know the full story. Because every acronym has a story behind it, right? And therefore, in front of the, after the story, you have the acronym. You have the idiom. So similarly for us, if you look at the acronym, you don't need to read the whole manifesto to understand what the acronym means. For example, our political parties. If you want to know what the PAP stands for, the Workers' Party stands for, the SDP stands for, you can read their manifestos. Or you can take a look at their acronyms. Then you know what they actually mean. If you vote for the PAP, you just expect to pay and pay, right? That's for the PAP. And if you decide to be like Aljunied and vote in the Workers' Party, what they wanted to tell everybody was, why pay? Then finally, at the end, vote in the SDP, so don't pay. Singapore is really crazy with acronyms. In fact, most Singaporeans can have an entire conversation just using acronyms. In fact, I was talking to one Chinese student, and told me, do you know, he didn't say it that way. Do you know what NTU stands for, really? He said, no. I said, what? Nanyang Toilet University. I said, why? Is it because it sucks? No. Because there's a lot of toilets. So can be every 100 meters, every floor there's a toilet, and it's full of toilets. It's very interesting because as a technological university, we have so much toilets. But you know what we really short of? PowerPoints.
True story.
PowerPoints. True story, right? We're short of PowerPoints and study rooms. So I can just imagine the Nanyang Chronicles. Student in a revolt. Nanyang Technological University lack PowerPoints. That was a joke, by the way. Okay, recently I saw something really bizarre here. I was walking around Clarke Quay, I saw something really very strange. I saw a white guy dating a white girl. It was so strange. I was like,
whoa.
That is absolutely... I don't know if you feel me here, but I said, whoa, it's so strange. So I started to think of what, because then I was talking to one of my friends, said, oh, it's a play on yellow fever. You guys know what yellow fever is?
Yeah.
It's basically white guys having a fetish for Asian girls. That's yellow fever. So I could imagine what a girl who likes dicks, what kind of disease would that be called? Bird flu. And if you have a white girl that likes Chinese guys, smallpox.
Oh, dude.
Okay, next joke. Moving on. Okay. So you guys not gonna like this. There are three classes. I was telling my friend from the engineering school, then he told me that there are officially three classes in Triple E. There is the third class, four classes. Third class, second lower, second upper, and the China class. Okay, you know that in with acronyms, there's in Singapore, there is a the first people to send out to war is the ADF. Other than the commandos. You guys know what the ADF is? ADF, right?
Yeah.
ADF. So actually, I missed an entire joke here. Okay, I basically have nothing against foreigners. I'm nothing against foreigners. We Singaporeans, we really need foreigners. We really do. Because we don't have enough kids and basically we're so dependent on them. And a lot of Singaporeans take it for granted. You know, we like fun of the foreigners here who are working crap jobs or something like that, we make fun of them, or we don't appreciate them for the stuff that they do here. Come on, did we really build our HDBs? Did we really build our MRTs? No, foreign workers came here and built it for us. In fact, we are so spoiled. So, and if Malaysia ever decides to attack Singapore, and they attack Singapore on a Sunday, the first group they activate is not the ADF, not the army, they activate the MDF, the Maid Defense Force. It's going to send all the maids, because nobody's carrying their bags, so how are you going to fight a war? Alright, I'll leave you guys with this. There's Singapore and India are very similar countries. Really are. Our flags are very similar. Red and white. It's only one difference. We're both islands, we are very multicultural. I'd say there's one difference between the Singapore flag and the Indonesia. So I've been to Singapore and Indonesia. We are a 5-star country. Okay. So okay. You guys heard of did I tell the Indian flag joke last time I was here?
No.
Did I tell the Indian flag joke last time? Hey, everybody here know how the Indian flag looks like? Indian flag.
Is it the one with the
color? Okay, now I'll tell the Indian flag joke later. I'll tell you from now. Okay. You guys know how the Indian flag looks like? Right, you guys know, right? Indian flag is like orange, white, and green. Alright, you can't remember the sequence, just remember it's curry on white rice and banana leaf. Another joke is the lies that men tell women. Okay, I'm gonna do some sex jokes and see how it goes. The lies that men tell women. Right, one of the lies that men tell women is that swallowing keeps you young. Right, have you guys heard this joke before? Have you ever heard this line that swallowing keeps you young? It's not true because you didn't look the same age. Okay, now.